locate the Egyptian Sphinx located on the Giza Plateau in Egypt?
We are there.
Around 1800, a French painter painted a depiction of the Great Sphinx with several men on top of the head of the Sphinx, with one of them half submerged, so to speak, in the head, as if there was an opening in the top center of the Sphinx's head, and the man was being raised or lowered into or out of the head. In the 1920s, an aerial photo appeared to show a hole in the top of the Sphinx's head. Later photos appeared to show no open hole in the top of the Sphinx's head, but where a hole would or could have been, a different colored rock or filler substance was there. It was a different color than the rest of the Sphinx, indicating that the head of the Sphinx may have been tampered or interfered with. Please examine the history of the Sphinx. Is there a cavity in the Sphinx's head that was explored at some point through an opening in the top of the head, or did this not happen?
Looks like there was a crack on the top with what looks like a small opening big enough to get your hand into, and it caused some curiosity. And so they began to dig and open. Seems like they went inside the opening out of curiosity. Why they made the opening so large was unnecessary. Continue.
Thank you. So you see explorers actually entering the Sphinx through the head.
That is correct. That is correct.
So when, put it this way, how many explorers were there who discovered this? The painting, which some people just chalk up to some artist's imagination, of course, that's why I'm asking the question, but the painting seems to depict three explorers doing this. How many people were aware of this opening in the head and explored it?
Looks like two initially. There's another third one standing further back. He doesn't seem terribly interested. He doesn't think it's that important. And he turns around and goes back and gets something to eat. The other two have childlike curiosity. And so they start to dig and hack away. Looks like they worked on it rather consistently to see what is there, completely unmindful of its historical context or value to anyone else. Just their own curiosity was important. They were having fun. Continue.
Thank you. What did the explorers find within the Sphinx's head?
Something there that looks like a spool. Like a wooden spool with something wrapped around it. Looked like there were some sticks or some tools. Looked like these had some writing on them. Looks like also one of the builders may have left a tablet with some personal thoughts on it. We do not see any gold. We do not see any treasure. We do see an alabaster jar or vase laid on its side so as not to tip over. The bottom of it looks rather narrow. Seem to have some oil in it. Nothing of any material value, you would say. It seems to be that these were well wishes, that they were originally put there as good luck. Well wishes. Almost like a time capsule, leaving a little piece of themselves behind. Hope for the future. Like little souvenirs that were left behind, but nothing of any material value like gold or silver. You see someone taking a bracelet off, but it was a woven bracelet that was sentimental to them, and they put it inside. These were the common workers that did the carving and the working in the area. Sentimental to them, you see, they spent a lot of time on this. Continue.
Sounds like a few keepsakes from the workers, but nothing terribly valuable. Did the explorers descend from the level of the head down further into the Sphinx, or was this not done?
Looks like backward toward the throat was a little bit of an opening there as well, inside. But it seemed it did not go all the way through for them, so they did not go further. It is not very smooth inside there. It was somewhat jagged and hard to move around in. They were like children in a hideout, somewhat stepping on the souvenirs. The souvenirs had no value to them. They just sort of stepped on them, or picked them up, looked them away, and then discarded them, tossed them off to the side. Looks like the alabaster jar is broken now. Continue.
Okay, thank you. These explorers, who were these people? Who do they work for?
These were not people from the area. They look to be Western in their clothing style, European. Odd mustache. They seem to be indicating British, though one has some affiliation with the French. The one less interested seems French. The other two playing inside the head look to be British. They want to be taken seriously. And they dress, and in their manner, they're quite arrogant. But they play around in there like they are children. Continue.
Thank you. So it sounds like these individuals did not discover the Hall of Records located beneath the Sphinx.
They did not.
Okay. Why did they close up the opening on the top of the head? Pretty much just to cover their tracks, or?
It looks like they were chastised by someone of more authority and dignity who's pointing a finger at them, wagging it, and yelling a little bit. What are you doing? What have you done? You're making a mess. So unprofessional. He's quite disgusted with them. He is rather serious about his work as an explorer, as a historian. He's very dignified. And the others are somewhat cringing. Oops. Doesn't look like they fill it in themselves. It looks like it's work that was hired by other hands. And the older man is saying, make sure it's done right. Rude. He was very irritated with them. Continue.
Thank you. Do you see these areas, like the head of the Sphinx, being uncovered and explored again, but this time with the whole world knowing about the activity?
Oh, there is quite a bit of fuss and fighting. The country of origin does not want it damaged. They are worried about the structural integrity. They are worried about it as a historical object, not as just a curiosity. It's a great headache. A lot of negotiation, a lot of push and pull, back and forth. The man who is in charge is very fearful. This monument is precious to him personally, not just to his country. And he is on his knees prayerful that they do not destroy it in their further exploration. And so he is kicking up quite a fuss. And the government is pulling on the reins backwards regarding this project. There are recommendations for the use of technology, type of ultrasound or scan that is able to penetrate quite deeply. It seems if they are satisfied with the scans, then they will allow further exploration, done very, very carefully, of course, but more like scans before surgery, very carefully planned. And technology is advancing to the point where this is possible now, as it will be in the future. Continue.
Thank you. Now, if you examine under the right ear of the Sphinx, under the right ear, there appears to be a rectangular-shaped indentation in the rock, and within that, a separate piece of stone. What do you see is the significance of that area? Some people speculate it's like a keyhole, almost, or could open it, but this is speculation. What do you see this as?
We see a couple of different things. It almost looks like a plug for something to be plugged into, something to be fitted into it, like a cord plugging into the wall. We see, we are trying to go back further in history here. There are those who have their opinions and are pointing inside the Sphinx, saying that this indicates something in there, the point of an entrance inside, he is saying, that can be accessed from this point. That was meant to be accessed from this point, he says. One of the designers of the Sphinx is chuckling, saying, that's all fine and well. But this is referring to star charts and patterns with the Sphinx itself. He's pointing upward at the stars. He says there's a pattern here, and it corresponds to these stars. It's not just about something as mundane as what's inside. We do everything with a reason. Everything here is heavenly ordained, you would say. And so for him, he considers any other meaning of this to be somewhat lowly and unimportant. Continue.
So lastly, how does this indentation under the right ear of the Sphinx, how does that correlate with the stars? Like what constellation or star pattern, and how would it correlate with that?
He is pointing to the three stars that correspond to the pyramid, and then on the last star, he is raising his arm up, and this one is for the Sphinx. But on the horizon, there are coming two beams of light that are hitting that spot. Those would be from further away. And acknowledgement to another dimension. More of a nod, if you will. But the top point is for the last star that corresponds to the pyramid right above there, you would say. And all three of those point to the Sphinx as the guardian. Continue.